Hello friends, my name is Tushar and today we are going to talk about how to find minimum spanning tree using Prim's algorithm. In another video, I talked about how to find minimum spanning tree using Kruskal's algorithm, and both Prim and Kruskal's algorithm are greedy algorithm. So what is a spanning tree of an unrected graph? A spanning tree is a subgraph of a graph such that all n vertices are connected to each other and there are total n minus 1 edges in this subgraph. So basically there is no cycle in this subgraph. What is a minimum spanning tree? A minimum spanning tree is a spanning tree of a weighted undirected graph such that the sum of the weight of the edges is minimum. So suppose we have this graph here. Here we have four vertices A, B, C, D. If we pick these three edges A, B, B, C, and C, D, we get a minimum spanning tree and the sum of their weights is 1 plus 1 plus 1, that is 3. For Prim's algorithm, we need a binary heap which supports decrease key operation and which also supports contains and find operation. So in the next section, let's quickly look at this data structure before talking Prim's algorithm. Also, if you don't know what binary heap is, I highly recommend you to read about binary heap before watching this video. Our minimum binary heap or priority queue needs to support these four operations: extract, min, add, contains, and decrease. A regular binary heap already supports extract, min, and add in O of log n time and in O of log n time. And we also need it to support contains and decrease in O of one time and O of log n time. Let's see how this works. So if you know about a regular minimum binary tree, we know that value at every node is less than or equal to both its children. So minus 1 is less than or equal to 2 and 6. 2 is less than or equal to 4 and 5. 6 is less than or equal to 7 and 8. So this satisfies all the properties of minimum binary heap. Also, we know that values of the minimum binary heap are stored in array. So this is just a logical diagram. In reality, this pair is stored at location 0, this pair is stored at location 1, location 2, location 3, 4, 5, and 6 of array. To get the left child, we apply this formula 2i plus 1. So to get this guy's left child in the array, replace 0 with I, so 2 into 0 plus 1, so that's 1, so this is left child, and 2 into 0 plus 2, so this is right child. For 2's left child, we replace I with 2, so 2 into 2 plus 1, so that's 5, and 2 into 2 plus 2, so that's 6, so that's its right child. And to get a parent, for example, to get 4's parent in array, we replace 4 with I, so 4 minus 1, 3 by 2, so that's 1, so 4's parent is 1. So this is how regular binary heap works. Now to support these two contains and decrease operation, we need another map, we need another data structure map to do that efficiently. And in this map, we are going to store this key. So every pair here is identified by this key, unique value key. And the second value here is just used to position them in this binary heap. So now to check, so the way this map works is, the key here is this key, and the value here is the position in the array. So A is stored at location 0, B is stored at location 1, C is stored at location 2 of array, D is stored at location 3, E at 4, F at 5, and G at 6. So now to support contains operation, what we do is we check, does this heap contains C? So all you have to do is go to this map and check, does this map have a key C? And yes, it does. So this can be done in a map in O of one time. What about decrease operation? So let's say we have to decrease the value of 5 to minus 2. So decrease this 5 to minus 2. This F to minus 2. So what we do is we first come to this map, check where this F is stored. So F is stored at location 5, so we reach this point. Now we change the value here to be f and minus 2. At this point, it violates a property of binary heap, minimum binary heap, because this value is less than its parent. So using this formula, I minus 1 by 2, so 5 minus 1 by 2, so that's 2. We check if this value is less than this. It is. So we are going to swap this data here. So here we get f minus 2. And here we have C, 6. And also, we have to go into this corresponding map and change their locations. So F's new location is 2, and C's new location is 5. Now this f is still violating this property here, because minus 2 is less than minus 1. So again, we are going to do a swap here. So a minus 1 is here, and f minus 2 is here. So then, now our f's new location is 0. And A's new location is 2. So this is how we support decrease key operation in O of log n time. So hopefully this helps you understand how we are going to use these two data structures combined together to have these four operations in the Prim's algorithm. So in the next section, let's look at the Prim's algorithm. The way this algorithm works is, first we take all the vertices, put in this heap plus map data structure which we just discussed with the value infinity, and the node, the vertex from which we are going to start as a value 0. In this case, we are going to start from A, but we can start from any vertex. Then we are going to explore neighbors of A, in this case D and B, and check if they exist in this heap plus map, and if they do, and if the value they are attached to is greater than this edge weight, then we update their values. So D infinity, so we update it to 1, A's value is 3, so we update it to 3. And then we keep repeating this process, then extract min again and keep repeating this process until there are elements in this heap plus map data structure. Also, we are going to store, and we are going to have another map going from vertex to edge, which is going to store for every vertex which edge is contributing to the minimum value in this heap plus map data structure. This is to get the final result. And in here, we're going to store the final result. So let's do a dry run on this graph here. So we start from A, we do an extract min here. So the minimum value is 0, so A. So A comes out of this heap plus map data structure. Then we are going to explore neighbors of A. So first neighbor of A is, say, D. So D contains in this heap plus map, and the value attached with D is infinity, which is greater than 1. So we update this value to 1. And in here, we are going to store this. Say that D is introduced, the minimum value for D is coming from this edge AD. Then we're going to explore other neighbor of A, which is B. B is in this map here. And B, the minimum value of B is, the value attached with B is infinity, which is greater than 3. So this value becomes 3. And we'll indicate here that B's minimum value edge is coming from this edge AB. So as we discussed heap plus map, the decrease operation can happen in O of log n time, and contains operation can happen in O of 1 time. So at this point, we're done exploring all the neighbors of A, so we are done with A. And then we're going to do an extract min on this heap plus map, which can again be done in O of log n time, and get the next value. So the next min here is 1. So we'll take 1 out, and then we're going to check which edge contributed to this value 1. And to do that, we come here and see which edge contributed to that. So D is AD edge. So AD will go into this final result, which has all the edges in the minimum spanning tree. Then we are going to remove this guy from here, from this heap plus map data structure, and explore its neighbors. So D's first neighbor is 6. And E is in this heap plus map data structure, it is. And the value attached with this guy is greater than 6. So we'll replace this with 6. And we will say that E is coming from DE. Then we're going to explore another neighbor of D. So that's B. And the value B is in this heap plus map, but the value with B is 3 is not less than this value 3. So we are just going to ignore this edge here. And then we're going to look at the next neighbor of D, which is C. So C is in this heap plus map, and the value at C is infinity, which is greater than 1. So we'll change this value to 1. And we'll say that C is coming from DC, CD, edge CD. At this point, D is done exploring all its neighbors. So we again go into this heapless map and do an extract min here. So this time, C1 comes out. So first thing we check is who introduced this C1 into this heapless map. And that's, we go to this vertex and that is CD. So CD is also in final result. And we're going to do an extract min on this heapless map. Now we're going to explore neighbors of C. So C, first neighbor we explore is B. Now the value stored with B right now is 3, while this edge has a weight 1, which is less than 3. So this edge is better than what we have in here, so we'll change this to 1. And we'll say that B's edge is BC. Then we're going to explore other neighbor of C, so that's D. D is not in this heapless map data structure, so we'll ignore D. And then we're going to explore F. F is there in this data structure, and the value attached with F is infinity, which is greater than 4, so we're going to replace this with 4. And we are going to say that F is coming from this HCF. Then we are going to explore this neighbor E, and the value attached with E right now is 6, which is greater than this edge weight 5. So we are going to replace this with 5. And in here we are going to say that E is coming from CE now. At this point of time, we're done exploring all the neighbors of C. So we again go here and do an extract min. So at this point, we're going to extract B out of this heapless map. And we're going to go and check which edge introduced B, and that is BC. So BC will go into the final result. And we're going to remove B from this heapless map data structure. Now we're going to explore neighbors of B. So first neighbor of B is A. It is not there in this heapless map data structure, so we ignore it. This another neighbor is D. D is also not there, so we ignore it. Another neighbor is C. C is also not there in this heapless map, so we ignore it as well. So now we move to the next. We do an extract min on this heapless map. So next time we get is F is 4. So first thing we do is check who introduced F, and that is HCF. So CF is also in final result. And we'll remove F4 from here. So we'll explore neighbors of F. So the first neighbor of F is C, but C is not in this data structure, so we'll ignore it. And the next neighbor of F is E, and the value attached with E here is 5, while this edge gets it done in 2, so we'll replace this 5 with 2. And we'll say that E is now coming from EF. And then at this point of time, we are done exploring all the neighbors of F. So we go back here and we extract this last guy out and we check who introduced this value to. So that's EF. So EF is also in final result. And we remove this guy from here and we look at its neighbors. So we go to D. D doesn't exist in this map, in this data structure. C doesn't exist here. And F doesn't exist here. So we are totally done exploring E at this point of time. So we go back here. At this point, this heapless map data structure has no elements. It means that all the vertices have been covered and we got our minimum spanning tree edges. So the edges for this minimum spanning tree is this 1, this 1, this 1, this 4, and this 2. So let's analyze the time and space complexity. Space complexity is pretty straightforward. This, we are storing result, we are storing this map, and we are storing heapless map data structure. In the worst case, the space complexity will be E plus V, because we might have to store all the edges of this graph. What about the time complexity? So we are performing this operation on, so we are performing, so as many edges we have, we are performing that operation that many times on this heap plus map data structure. In the worst case, the size of this heap plus map data structure will be O of V, basically the size of the entire heap, entire graph. And we are doing, in worst case, E operations on this thing. And we know that contains works in O of one time, extract min works in O of log n time, add works in O of log n time, and decrease key works in O of log n time. So in worst case, the time complexity will be O of E into log of V, where V is the size of this heap plus map data structure. So again, the space complexity is O of E plus V, and then the time complexity will be E of O of E log V. So in the next section, let's look at the code for this algorithm.
So the name of the function is primMST. It takes in a graph and returns a list of edges which form the minimum spanning tree. Let's first initialize the data structure which we are going to use. So the first one is the binary min heap, which is the heap plus map data structure I discussed in before. So if you want, you can look at the class to see how I've implemented it. Then the next data structure is a map from vertex to edge, basically storing the edge which provided the minimum value for this vertex in this min heap. And then finally, this is a list of edges which is just going to store the final result. So first thing we do is we iterate through all the vertices in this graph and add them to the min heap with the value integer.max value, which is basically an infinity value. And then we randomly select a start vertex from this graph and then decrease the weight of that vertex in this min heap to zero. So basically this is the first vertex which will get selected. And then we go into this while loop until this min heap is not empty. Then we select a vertex. So then our current will be the first, will be the minimum value vertex in the min heap. And then we check if this current has a corresponding edge in this vertex to edge graph map or not. So this will be missing for the start vertex, but this value should be available for every other vertex. So we check if the spanning tree edge is not null. If it is not, then we add it to the final result. And then we are going to get every edge for this current vertex, and then get the adjacent vertex for this edge. And then we are going to check if this adjacent vertex exists in the main heap or not. And if it does exist, then is the weight attached with this vertex is greater than the edge weight or not? If both the conditions are true, basically if it exists in the main heap and the weight attached, the current weight attached with this adjacent vertex is greater than the edge weight, then we are going to go into the main heap and decrease the value of that vertex to the current edge weight. And then we are going to add this vertex and the edge into this vertex to edge map. And then we are going to repeat the process for other edges of this current vertex. And once we are done totally exploring this vertex, we are going to go back and go to the top and repeat the same process, basically again doing an extract min for and getting another current vertex and then going through its neighbors and updating the min heap. And finally, the result will be stored, final result will be stored in this result list, and we'll just return this list. So again, the time complexity is O of E plus V, and space time complexity is E log V, and space complexity is O of E plus V. So this is all I have to talk about Prim's algorithm. Please like this video, share this video, comment on this video, check out my Facebook page, facebook.com/tusharroy25, and check out my GitHub link, github.com/missionpieceinterview wiki. Thanks again for watching this video.